Hello there. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm the host, Damon Pettit, and we are getting ready to review St. Louis Ray Series G, or Siri G. Let's get this thing out of the wrapper first, if I can. That's the kind of important part. It's nice, natural wrapper there. Looks pretty. Kind of a pretty look to it. Too bad. Let's give her a cut. Give her a light. And smoky. How's everybody doing today, huh? I think the draw is pretty good. Should be. Little bit of spice right at first. Bit of spice. Nice flavor though, so far. How you doing? Here we go. Forgot to get my music ready, so we'll be getting that ready while I'm talking. This baby is a Nicaraguan wrapper, Nicaraguan binder, and then it's actually a blend of gotta get the music, okay? It's a blend of Nicaraguan, Honduran, and Peruvian. Actual Peruvian tobacco. And I've really never seen a blend of Peruvian tobacco. I mean, maybe I just haven't run into it. I don't know. I gotta decide what I feel like listening to. Let's do a little bit of... I'm going to do some Harry Connick Jr. today, my friends. Once it starts, we'll know how loud it is. We'll see how that turns out. Still trying to wake up. It's really early in the morning. Okay. Harry Connick Jr. is trying to wake me up. Sorry. I should have had this already and I forgot about it. So excited to smoke a cigar. Wow, really? Okay. Very tasty so far. Let me get a little rinse for the coffee here. Freshly brewed coffee from the region of Wyoming, United States. I'm kidding, I'm not exactly sure where this coffee's from. Coffee though, it's actually pairing well with this cigar. A little bit of the spice that's going on. Your face. kind of get a thing of what I'm tasting here. Sometimes it's very difficult. It's very, I mean, a lot of them are, you know, have the similarities usually of cedary wood and stuff like that. Right now I'm definitely getting the cedar taste, but I've noticed one thing while I'm trying to get, it's actually almost like a, like a dried fruit, like a dried mango, believe it or not, but with a, you know, with like the wood tints in there. Very, very interesting, very good though. You know, like a lot of you with a different palate might say, this tastes exactly like a lima bean to me, but I don't know. So you always kind of gotta draw on your own taste as well. It's kind of smoking a little bit, starting to kind of, we'll see if it stays kind of crooked, that's all, but it should be okay. Did a lot of research trying to find out who makes this cigar. Not very easy. I still really haven't got any answers to any of that. Can't find a website. Only thing I could find so far that it, and if I can find it here within this next day, I'll put it all on the screen so you can see it. One thing I have noticed about putting something on the screen through YouTube anyway, because YouTube has their little deal, you know, where you can insert, which is how I usually do things right now, which is going to have to stop because I noticed when I watch it on like an iTouch or on the phone, it doesn't come out. That I don't like. So all that I put on there never shows up if somebody's looking on a, you know, I don't know how many people watch on a mobile device, but I'm assuming if it's not coming out on an iTouch that it also might not come out on an iPad. So that's kind of pissing me off. So I'm gonna look into getting a better movie making software. You know, some simple stuff, but also I have to be able to handle the file that I use for the video. So that's that whole thing. I've been looking for that. So it's a little bit important for me to be able to do that because that's kind of where I put the last of the tasting notes usually. I'm going to have to definitely start putting it in the description of the video and like on the YouTube site where I post it mostly, and then on the other sites like Vimeo and my own website, CigarReviewTV.com. So we'll have to gotta get some things rolling differently to make it a complete review show. It's it's working out pretty well. Yeah, see, it's starting to burn very like this. Should be more like that. And the burn, the burn line, how thick and black that is. Usually the thinner that line and more fine it is, better aged it is. That's what I've learned before. If that's true, then where does that leave this little guy, huh? Well, the last of the preseason football games was this week. There's one more game, I think. I don't know if that's today or tomorrow. I really haven't hardly watched any of the games. I despise preseason. Not because they're not necessary, but because they don't mean anything. And you can kind of get excited about your team if they look real good and stuff, but then you find out that, you know, there's been, as we all know, there's been teams that have won every preseason game and that have lost every regular season game. Hello, Detroit. This cup is almost the size of my head, isn't it? That either means I got a big cup or a little tiny head. It's a big cup. I don't have the golf ball sized head, thank you. I've been wanting to, with every cigar, I try to make sure I know about the maker and, you know, some behind the scenes stuff of the cigar. It really is disappointing to, I will have to say that whoever makes this cigar, if you're out there, get a website. Contact me, I'll make you a website if you like. Really, I really will. It's not that difficult. I have one. I actually have a couple. And I don't make anything, and I don't sell anything. But if I did sell these, I would have a site for it. It's kind of important, really. It's, you know, that today's age, everything is online. Everything. And, I'm not saying that that's the only way it should be, but it's a good place to start. So, if you're walking down the street and you think, wonder what's going on with that, what do? You take out your phone, you look for it, you find it online. Right? You don't go to the nearest bookstore, walk to the bookstore that has to be 8 blocks down the road and see if they have something there about it. That's what we used to do, right? Like the library and stuff like that, but I'm sure still quite a few people probably do use that as a big reference, but I don't. Library. I've been to a library a long time, but used to be kind of a pretty cool resource. You go rent movies and a lot of stuff there. I know, you know, should probably get books there and stuff, but always been more of a fan of buying a book. I've never liked borrowing a book, having to bring it back. What about you? You read a lot? What do you read about? If I read a book, I like it to be more nonfiction. So, like, since I like to read things that are true and, you know, true events and stuff like that, I would never buy a book written by Dick Cheney or Donald Rumsfeld or any of those people. I'll just leave that at that. But, yeah, it's smoking pretty nice. It's not too bad. It's got a decent flavor still. It's got a nice aroma. It has a great draw. And this is the Rothschild, by the way. It is not a Figurado. It is not a pyramid. It's a Rothschild. Because I didn't really say anything, so I figured I better put that in there. I like the mixture of tobacco. It definitely has a nice flavor to it. It's the spiciness has kind of gone away. It's that first hit that you're when you're lighting it and stuff is kind of hot. Right there is more of a, getting to be some more of a nut tone. I always kind of don't like saying a nut tone, but that's really what it's got, nuts. There's a lot of you out there with, how shall we say, twisted warped minds that you think that I'm smoking a nut. Just heard firecrackers or gunshots. More than likely it's firecrackers. So, heard it again. Let's hope again it's firecrackers. But I was just joking about the nuts. Not as far as taste there, but what I was saying. Just a joke. And I was pretty much referring to one of my friends. You know who you are. It's very nice. The whole mixture of the smell, some coffee, and this music brings back a lot of memories right now to me as far as where I really got started with this whole thing, which is, I don't know if you'll be able to, probably won't be able to see that. Right there, the yellow logo. And that's for Havana's Fine Cigars. And this is when we had both stores. I love that place. I tell you what, that was... Obviously, if I could have seen into the future, I would have ended up staying there. And I would have bought that place somehow. Had no idea that they would have ever sold it. Of course, now they don't exist. They're all gone. But, it was a great place. It was a really, really nice place to buy and relax and smoke a cigar. Used to have one customer come in when I was at the downtown store, downtown Denver. It was such a cool place to be able to be right there. I mean, tons of people walk by, and it was just very cool. But anyway, I'd have this one guy come in every morning. He'd buy a Paul Grammarian cigar. He'd usually buy a few different ones, but he'd buy that one, sit down, read his paper, smoke it, and just kind of never really talked very much, but it was just kind of cool that was his place to come and relax and have a cigar, and I miss that, like you wouldn't believe. So, but that was some good stuff there. So I'm hoping to find a place like that. I mean, there are a couple places that I could go and relax and have a cigar. So it's fantastic, but I have to really pick one, you know? Let me knock the ash off this. See, at least it's got a little... I think it's rolled. Not so great. It's okay. It wasn't rolled bad or anything, but as you can tell, like how that came off of it, kind of even left like almost a indentation and everything. And something's been rolled like really, really good. It just comes off and even has a little bit of a round cap on it when it comes off. So, not this one. Not bad though. I mean, this is not a bad cigar. Don't get me wrong. I'm enjoying it. Very much enjoying the aroma. Enjoying the taste. It's not overly harsh in any way right now. Wow, I'm really going over, aren't I? I'm so sorry. Tell you what I'm going to start doing. For the most part, the shows will still be around 20 minutes. Usually I'll try to make them at least not much longer than that. But if they do, what I will do is around the 15-minute mark, I'll have the different things come out on the screen. I will also have them, all the tasting notes and stuff, next to the video somewhere. If it's on YouTube, it'll be in the description. If it's on my website, it'll be on the side, or actually probably underneath the video on that. On all the other video, shoot, I gotta figure out a way to do that. It'll have to be starting now, of course, but like, because if you go back to all the other videos, it's not gonna be on there, and I am not gonna go through 50 videos and put it all on the screen, that kind of thing, with the new software. So, as this show evolves, which it is every day, every time I do one, I'll do it that way. But that way, if I go over, the tasting part will kind of end around the 15, to, you know, 17-minute mark. And then you can go on your way if you like. And you can hang out for the rest of the time and smoke with me if you want. That's kind of what I've intended in the first place, is love people to be able to, if they want to sit back and have a cigar, if they want to, you know, throw my show on, if they don't have anybody else there and it's just something that they kind of want to hang out and watch somebody smoke and talk to them. And you can talk back to me. Just don't let anybody know. They might, you know, they might wonder. But it's kind of the way this show, in a way for me, I intended it to be, is to be something where it's a smoke along. Still gonna do the Skype show, don't, things like that can take a while, especially with me, because one, this is only my 51st show, which is, it's getting up there, but another thing I have to consider is, there's a lot of you that I have to find a way to get a good time, and then I've got one person with an email, so tell you what, if you would like to do a Skype show, you can send me a personal message in many different ways. Either on YouTube, you can send me a personal message. You can email me, which is Damon, which is Damon, okay, at CigarReviewTV.com. Or you can go right to my, actually, let me see. I have that on my web. I don't even know if I have it. Mail link on my webpage to contact. It's unbelievable. So I'll have to go to my website today and put that on there. That way you can just contact me right through there. You can get on Twitter. At Cigar Review TV is my Twitter name. For the show anyway. Still very nice tasting cigar. Only part that to me downgrades it a little bit, just the burning of it. Very, very poor in that realm. So the little bit of rolling and stuff, not so perfect. It's, the one thing about it, is I pay like $5 for it. So it wasn't like this is not a high-end cigar by any means. So that's one good thing about it. It's worth what I paid for it. I'll have to give it that. It's worth what I paid for it. This is not a high-end cigar. If it was, I'd be extremely disappointed, especially after the last one. But it's not a high-end one. I wouldn't call it that. So it's kind of it's worth the money. It's not too bad that way. So you can give that one. I'd give it a try. You know, if you're picking out like a bunch of different cigars for yourself to throw in a humidor or whatever, just throw one of those in. That's not too bad. It's, you know, like I said, it's not my favorite. And it's definitely, I am disappointed with that. I mean, I've had a couple, I've literally bought a few $3 cigars that have smoked really well, so. You can tell it's actually wanting to go out, so. That's where the whole burn really comes in handy when it burns well. It won't go out like that. Up to 26 minutes. Time to shut the show down. It's been good talking to you. I'm going to enjoy the rest of this cigar. Again, I'll put the tasting notes and stuff around it. You'll see it somewhere. Things will evolve better. I'll get a better software. It'll actually be on every device at some point now. Pretty soon. Probably won't be with this review, but it'll be in a review or two down the road. And I really thank you for watching. I really do. I hope it's enjoyable for you. Any kind of information for me to help me make a better show is always appreciated. Any comments, I always love. Feel free to comment, please, because I know that makes me know you're watching. See, it's going out. So you can do it, or you can give it a pass. I wouldn't go right for this baby, okay? But anyway, take care of yourself. I'll be seeing you very soon again, a day or two here. Actually, I'm gonna go get some cigars today, later on today. It's pretty early still, so nothing's open. But I will be talking to you all soon. You enjoy yourself. Thank you very much for watching. Like I said, any comments, I'm always, always delighted to see them. Take care of yourself. I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.